like the video and subscribe right now, or Titan Doggo will crush your house. When did you lose your childhood innocence? I was 7. My parents said I had a sister named Sarah Connor who was killed when I was younger. They made me watch The Terminator 15 minutes later. Marvelous. I can't wait till I have a child, so I can pretend certain sci-fi films are actually factual documentaries. Darling, this is called Alien. This is why there are no more shuttle launches. When I was 11, my dad shot my dog in the head in our backyard while I was at school. My dad is a really ducked up guy. So anyway, that afternoon as I was walking home from the bus stop, dad drove up and got me, which was weird. Dad was drunk. When we got home, discovered that the dog was gone. He told me Rusty had run away. I freaked out, ran barefoot through the backyard, and threw Rust his brains, grabbed a leash, and went to search for my dog. Hours later, my ma found me walking up the street, sobbing and calling for Rusty. My feet were raw and bloody. By then I was suspicious that dad done something. I was furious. I took him out to the backyard, still oblivious to the brains everywhere, and still barefoot, and yelled, "What the duck did you do to my dog?" He just kind of smirked, told me it would be okay, and went back inside. Later my mom sent me up to bed. Dad was still drunk. My sister was already asleep in her room. I lay there furious and afraid for my poor Rusty. Unbeknownst to me, as I lay awake in bed, my ma and dad were having an epic power struggle downstairs, in which my dad produced another gun after confessing that he'd killed the dog. When I heard a commotion, I ran downstairs. Mom was in the kitchen, and she shouted, "Margaret, grab your sister and run. Grandma will pick you up." And so I did. I got my 8-year-old sister out of bed, and we ran down the street. We were barefoot, and I can remember how my own feet sounded on the asphalt. I remember telling my sister to run faster. I don't think of that day as the day I lost my childlike innocence that had been worn away by years of my father's total douchebaggery, but rather as the day I became an adult. We were whisked away to my aunt's house later that night. I'd finally been told what had happened. As my uncle and grandma got my sister all set up, my aunt took me into her bedroom and handed me a little red box. I opened it, and she asked, "You know how to shoot?" Yes, I knew how to shoot. My dad had taught me. "Good. You protect them if you have to. And don't worry, my ma survived." When my buddy was in elementary school, his parents would take him to Toys R Us where, if he was really good, he could choose one toy. He would peruse the entire store before making his important selection. On one such trip, he selects a 36-piece magic set. It's a bit costly, but his mom justifies it because he has been particularly good the last week or so. On the way home in the car, he sits quietly grinning with his magic set in his lap and wonders how the kids at school will react once he reveals to them that he, in fact, knows magic. Upon arriving home from the toy store, my buddy races off upstairs to finally learn some magic. Keep in mind, he thinks he's on the verge of being a legitimate Harry Potter. After about 20 minutes, he comes downstairs dragging the box of magic behind him, walks up to his mom with his head hung quite low, and asks her if it would be okay to take the magic set back to the store. His mother, concerned with the defeated look on her child's face, asks him why. He looks up at her and very solemnly states, "It's not real magic, it's just a bunch of tricks." I think it was the summer before the start of my senior year of high school. I knew I'd probably be working the following summers through college, so I took a moment to reflect on what was probably my last day of summer until retirement. I watched the sunset. Not quite childhood, but a huge change for me. Getting off of the bus after the senior party, I knew many of those people I would never see again. As I was driving away from the school, I knew I would likely never have occasion to come to that place again. Now I live right next door to it, lol. When I showed my 9-year-old cousin my penis and she refused to show me her vagina. We had a deal, man. Women. A bunch of illusions. A trick is something a whore does for money. Or cocaine. When I was in about first or second grade, I was an imaginative kid. My grade school was in front of a big wooden area in suburbia. At recess, I started telling my friend about the man who lived in the woods. Things like, "See the tree stump? That's his stove. And that fallen over tree? That's where he set up his house. Similar thing to looking at the clouds and seeing dragons. In my head he was a Rip Van Winkle type of character. Pretty soon I had a bunch of friends who'd come and listen while I talked about Man in the Woods. This ended badly when one of the kids mentioned this to a teacher and I ended up in several hours of interviews with the principal, teachers, and guidance counselors over whether there was a child molester hiding in the woods and whether I had been touched by him. I had never heard of most of the things they were talking about. I kept saying it was just a game I made up, but they couldn't believe a kid would bother doing that purely for fun. Pretty much killed the innocence right there. My mother still won't allow Rainbow Chips Ahoy into the house. I'm 25 and live 8 hours away from home. To put this into context, because I threw the most epic fit when I found out there wasn't a party in every box. I just wanted to party. I can't recall a specific moment, but the worst feeling is when you revisit a place that you have not seen since childhood, and it is smaller and less impressive than you remember. I think the biggest tragedy of growing up is that simple things no longer give me a sense of awe and fascination. Try acid, man. When my mom was in the next room holding a 9mm to her head, with my stepdad egging her on to pull the trigger because her son, me, doesn't love her. I opened that door as a 9-year-old kid, called him an asshole, and told her I loved her. Wow, that's really brave for a 9-year-old. I was 13, and I had a job. My bank account tipped over the $1,000 mark for the first time, and I was beaming with pride holding my balance book, thinking of all the things I could buy. My dad looked over my shoulder, and took my book and said, "Son, I think it's about time you started saving for your education." He wiped my account clean, it was in trust, and put it into resps. I was so bitter for that. He probably did that another 5 times over the next 3 years and I hated him for it, until I was able to pay cash for my first year uni. That was my real first lesson in planning ahead. The bubble jets in the swimming pool. The ducking bubble jets in the swimming pool. Oh yes. You can always tell if when a little kid has discovered those. They'll be talking to you while they're in the pool, then all of a sudden, they'll just stop talking and make that face. I was enjoying one of those once when I was about 7, when my mom looked me dead in the eye and said, "I know what you're doing." When I found porn on the computer my grandfather gave me 2 days earlier, I was 12. I literally had a "I'm 12, and what is this moment?" I started independently looking at porn at around 12. The day I discovered the temporary internet files folder. It was like the sloppy seconds of internet porn. Ah ha ha ha, lovely way of looking at it. You were a porno bottom feeder. Haha, when I was little I found porn in the internet cache folder on my dad's computer. So I saved some pictures on a floppy disk, fitting 10 whole pictures, so that I could threaten to show it to my mom in the event he ever caught me looking at porn. When I was 12, sleeping on my aunt's hider bed, my uncle came in the house drunk, climbed in bed with me, and started poking me in the back with his penis. I started crying, and he kept telling me to be quiet, I would wake his kids. He left without doing anything, because I was crying so loud. The next morning he was sitting in his usual chair reading the comics, and laughing like nothing was out of the usual. I was heartbroken and ashamed. He had helped raise me. I never told anyone. Until I was an adult he died a few years after that incident. His liver malfunctioned from all the alcohol, and I was so happy. This might get buried but I'll share. A few years ago I had a crush on one of my teachers. I mean I really thought she was pretty. Weird thing was she felt the same way about me, and things just sort of happened, and I ended up losing my virginity to her. In hindsight, was pretty weird cause she was significantly older than me. Really it might have turned out okay, except that we got caught making out at school by a student hall monitor of all things. My kinda strict Jewish parents were considering filing charges. My mom wanted my teacher thrown in jail. Anyways, my teacher really went psycho and decided to run away to Spain or some ducking place. Being young and stupid I really thought about going and actually met her at the hotel before we were supposed to fly out of the country. Somehow the police found out about it though, and they showed up at the hotel to arrest her. Long story short, she wanted me to jump off the roof and die with her. I didn't of course, but she did. She fell like 10 stories and died. I live in a quiet, little, redneck, mountain town too, so this was huge news. When my parents split up, I was 11. Before then, the idea that moms and dads could even do that never entered my mind. After I understood they were only human and sometimes had conflicting needs, I grew up really fast. Especially when my mom started dating again. I can definitely see how this would really shatter the innocence of childhood. You spend your whole life thinking one blissfully ignorant thing and something happens that makes you rethink it all. At age 11. I guess this qualifies. I was about 15 feet away from a motorcycle crash that killed two people when I had just turned 14. This was the summer before high school and varsity tennis spent the summer practicing. Me and about three other incoming freshmen picked to make varsity were practicing on the court right next to an interstate, right 11. A teenager who had fallen asleep at the wheel, it was 3 p.m, crossed into the oncoming lane of traffic hitting a motorcycle carrying a man and his wife. There weren't any other cars around at the time, so the four of us ran across the interstate to a florist to have 911 dialed. My friend and I had both taken CPR and first aid training and foolishly thought we could help. I ended up puking within 30 seconds of stumbling onto one of the rider's boots that had their foot still inside of it. Additional, it also didn't help when my friend pointed out that one of the helmets among the wreckage still had the head inside. When I was a little girl in primary, elementary, school, I used to get bashed a lot by groups of older boys for being a loner and chubby. My mum always told me how we all go to a better place when we die, so one night, when I was 9, I started thinking of all the different ways I could kill myself, like drowning myself in the bathtub, or jumping in front of a bus. Every night has been the same from then on. I want to say I'm sorry. No, I didn't tease you, but I teased a girl like you, because I was too weak to resist the peer pressure of the bastards that I wanted to be accepted by. Decades later, I still remember and feel ashamed of it. The crazy thing is, I actually liked her. Patty B, if you should ever read this, you probably forgave me, but I'll never forgive myself. It breaks my heart that you were hurt so badly. I remember when I was 8 years old, I asked my dad what a condominium was, because I had seen the word on signs all around my neighborhood, and on TV and whatnot. He thought I asked him what a condom was. Looking back, he manned up to the situation like a boss, but that still doesn't make my 8-year-old mind prepared for shit like that. Around the same age, I watched nightly news every night. I had heard this word several times, and didn't know what it was. I hadn't had the talk yet, but when I asked my dad what is rape, he gave me the talk. My stomach jumped into my heart, and I felt dizzy. When I was sexually molested at 6 to 7 by our babysitter. I have only told 3 people in my life. Really can't believe anyone read this and cared enough to send me some encouragement. I was waiting for the smart ass karma whore remarks and was pleasantly surprised. Thanks again, Reddit. Watched a man who drowned get pulled out of the lake where we were swimming. I was about 11 and my friend and I were rowing out in our little inflatable boat over to all the commotion, thinking someone had a huge fish and needed some help. Talk about disappointment. I would have to say, when I was in like 4th grade, and it was Valentine's Day. Everyone was giving each other the bullshit cardstock Valentine's with maybe a lollipop taped to it, if their parents spent the extra money. I bought a heart full candy for a girl I liked in the class, my first crush. She saw it was from me, and gave me the patented girl-oo look. I was later told she threw it away. A few of us were over at a friend's house. I was 13 at the time. He was an only child of a single mom. She left to go to work, and shortly after she was gone, one of our friends is like, "Is she gone for sure?" After getting a confirmation that the coast was clear, he pulls this VHS tape out of his backpack while giggling, and hands it to the friend, whose house we were at. He pops it in the player, and seconds later this full-on hardcore porn scene is playing on the TV set. I was literally dumbfounded, as I had lived a pretty sheltered childhood, and now there I was staring at this close-up shot of two people ducking. My other friends were laughing awkwardly, and I just sat there in shock, unable to take my eyes off the screen. I was somewhere between 3 and 4, my mother was cheating on my father, and discussing this new man who was going to be my new dad. 9 months later, my brother was born, and it was pretty obvious he wasn't related to my real dad. New dad never came up again. Nobody ever talked about why my brother looked so different from the rest of us. You've been visited by a bald guy. this guy will give you a punch unless you comment, "I'm not a monster." Thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe for more daily videos.